I will talk about ships this morning. That's quite common in this day. And about, talk about noise. So I will make some noise about ship noise. Maybe it will be perceived as sound. Sound is positive, noise is negative. Okay, a short introduction. Some of the problems, the impacts, a project that will be started, and some conclusions. Sometimes ships cause large noise problems. It's not often the case, but sometimes it does. We're talking not about loading or unloading noise. Talk about auxiliary engines, funnel noise. And sometimes it's very loud and very low frequencies and will travel through the windows right in the houses and people can't sleep and start complaining. And there's a lot of problem. That's not often the case. But sometimes it happens. It happened over in Rotterdam, Schiedam, near Rotterdam, Vancouver, Canada, and Pembrokeshire in Great Britain. They had to take down the funnel and put a silencer, proper silencer, inside. Now, of course, that's not a very big problem if you do it right at the beginning, at the start of the building of the ship. But that doesn't work always. So we have the engines, the auxiliary engines that runs in port. We have the ventilation, and a lot of noise comes out of here. And then, of course, the funnel noise comes out over there. But that's something you all probably will know better than me. Okay, sometimes we have low frequency components, and that's below the 100 hertz. And you can hear it very far away. And the housing isolation is poor, and the sound just travels through your window, and it causes a lot of annoyance. I'll give you some idea about low frequency noise in this, in the 63 hertz octave band. And that really is annoying. I won't give you examples of it. I cannot sing that low. And if we start to sing, you really get annoyed. All right, solution, not that, that's of course quite proper, quite common, proper exhaust silencer will do the trick. If you have to put in afterwards, it costs a lot of money. Do it right when you start building. More often, in the Rotterdam port area, you have generally 250 complaints a year about ship noise. And that's not the really great problems, but more general problems. And last year, there were 1,400 complaints. People get aware of this problem and start phoning. And most of all, it's failing mufflers or aggregates and compressors, and sometimes even public address systems on ships. Now, the port of Rotterdam and Amsterdam, they have a problem with this noise. So it's a general noise, the common ships that come in, they have a problem. And they cannot regulate it because it's foreign territory and there are no rules. Now we have done, as a DGMR, we have done a lot of measurements on ships and we have created for several types of ship noise sound power levels depending on the dead weight tonnage. So the dead weight tonnage of the MMRs, that was a container, so the green line will be 118 decibel. That's not the decibel you will hear, but it's the sound power, the energy, the sound energy that comes off, but if you're close by, it will be a lot of noise. And it will carry on to the surroundings, and the surrounding will have their negative ideas about it. I've calculated the noise impact of ships at the Westport port, Amsterdam. The blue line is the noise coming from the ships, and the cyan color is the industrial noise. So they're very close together. You could say that the ship noise is the major part of the industrial noise that comes out of this area. So this is a problem for a port that wants to have good relationship with the surrounding area. The people living over here, they complain noise. Noise general from the port area, but especially from the shipping. As already was told, the ESPO ranking, noise is quite an important subject. Even now, it was number one in 2009, but still third place. And most of the noise, a large part of the noise, about 50%, is coming from the ships. So if a port authorities want to do something about noise, they do something about shipping noise. So how to control this noise? Now, that's the question where you come in, and I want to ask you for your help. The IMO says something about noise. The engine room, 110 decibels. That's called quite large. The bridge, 65. And the cabins, depending on the gross tonnage, 60 to 55. But no rules for the surrounding. No rules for what comes out of the funnel or the ventilation system. And that's something that should be incorporated as well. Of course, you get alternative marine power, and it would reduce the noise coming out of the ship. But of course, quite expensive, and it doesn't take away all the noise. You get a reduction for a bulk carrier about 10 decibels, but tanker, probably zero. Or a container, about 5 decibels. Row-row terminal, row-row ships with the large ventilation is about 0 decibels. So that's not always helping the case, and it could be done quite cheap as well. First of all, install a proper silencer, mostly in place, and secondly, if that's in place, put on silencer on vents. Usually they're not present, and they don't cost that much, about 1,000 euros per square meter. Or if you want to go a step further, a duct silencer that will reduce the noise by 20 decibels coming out of these ventilations, about 2,000 euros per square meter. Not too much, I think. But how do you get ships to build these ships with less noise? Port rates could be one of the issues that would enforce such things. Ship type and a London cargo weight, you could, with Green Award or ESI certification, could be 6 to 10% discount. And of course, you could add noise to this system. Amsterdam and Rotterdam port support this idea, but of course it would be better, as Jan Fransen also already told, it should be enforced in a general way. IMO would be a good step if they would take this direction. But of course, this will take a long time and could be faster. Okay, we want to start a noise and project on noise reduction. The objective is to reduce the noise nuisance of ports, nuisance imports from more ships. A practical measurement method of the source, so everybody can relate quite easily. Best practices, design tools, and decision tool to judge a ship if it's good or poor. And it should be worldwide. The project outline, we start in May, June, find a lot of ports that want to help to organize this project. We're looking for owners, shipbuilders worldwide, set up an organization scheme and a meeting schedule, and seek finance. Of course, it costs a lot of money, and the ports maybe want to help us or help themselves. In September, there will be an international meeting of interested parties, sign documents, and step three, that will take about 2 years, measuring protocol, mitigation measures, and design suggestions. So the conclusions. I can do it slowly now because I have 2 minutes time. More chip noise, important environmental factor. You should be aware of that. Mitigation measures are easily done. Cheap. Ship rewards can stimulate the use of silent ships and will help to improve the environment. And of course, that's something we all live in the environment. We should take care of it. Project on moorship ship noise reduction is on the way, and you could be part of it. Need your information to make this project work, but to make the right decisions. And silent ships are green for sea, and green for ports as well. Okay, thanks for your attention.